Thank you. Time to settle down, and everybody gather in for our history class today. So, can anybody tell me what we will be discussing today?
Yes, I know. It's my favorite story. It's a story about Jesus born on earth.
Oh, this is a good one. Gabriel tells me this story every year at Christmas.
Wait, Jesus was born on earth? I thought he was God's son.
He is, but he had to be born on earth to save all people from their sin.
That's why Paul calls him Savior sometimes. But before I explain all of that, let's begin with the story of his birth. So everyone sit still and listen quietly. Many, many years ago, God sent angels to a man named Joseph and a woman named Mary.
Gabriel was one of them. He's the best.
Yes, Aaliyah, it was Gabriel who went. Now no more interruptions, please. Angels were sent to inform them that they would give birth to God's son, Jesus. Mary was scared, and Joseph was too, but they knew what God had promised and entrusted him. As the days passed and Mary grew closer to having baby Jesus, a decree was sent through the land that everyone was going to have to pay taxes. Yes, Mary.
What is taxes? Is it something cool?
No. I don't think the people would say it's cool to pay taxes. Taxes are like money that you have to pay to their rulers. And in this case, Mary and Joseph had to travel a long way to pay their taxes. When they arrived to Bethlehem, Mary was ready to have the baby, but there was no place for them to sleep, so the innkeeper put them in the stable. Yes, Malia.
A dog sticky animal?
It was according to God's plan.
Yes. Yeah, this was exactly what was supposed to happen according to Gabriel.
Aaliyah, please stop interrupting. If you have something to say, then raise your hand and wait for me to ask them. Now, God knew and had planned for Jesus to be born in this stable. God said in his word that another name for Jesus was Emmanuel, which means God with us. He became as low as those that he was sent to save. He didn't even have his own better blanket the night he was born.
Royal David said, stood up.
sent a group of angels to tell some nearby shepherd boys about it. Yes, Aaliyah?
Gabriel was one of them. He's good best.
Yes, I'm sure he was with them. Anyways, while the shepherds were watching their sheep, the angel came and told them about Jesus. Then a whole group of angels came proclaiming peace and goodwill.
Thank you.
He is so worthy of all the glory and praise we could give him. We should never cease to sing his praises. That is why teaching you all this story is so important, so you can see just how much God loves you and just how worthy he is of our praise. Yes, Aaliyah.
You all will never guess who also loves to praise God.
Gabriel.
Shout again.
card, our upper class program, and the bells and the Christmas medley.
Thank you.
Well, today is the day.
Okay, I'm so excited.
Don't be such a party pooper, Tiffany. Today is a very important day. We've been tasked with having the perfect Christmas song.
I don't understand. Why is it so important that we find the perfect Christmas song? I mean, it's just another holiday celebrating the nativity of Christmas. Why is it important for the
Christmas? Because it's the day that Jesus was born.
So?
Jesus is the Savior of the world. What do you mean, so?
Okay. How about in between auditions, we explain a little bit more why Christmas is so special? And right now, we have our first group.
Our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing be.
Yeah. if our twin brothers were all better performers.
How would that be so lucky? So who are you now?
Man, I know that's what you mean.
Some of me are the... That's how my gun's endless.
Yeah, man, we had the perfect jingle for you.
We just thought that they could be more interesting.
Okay, please. Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore.
Oh,
I believe he is, but don't take my word for it. Let's ask John the Baptist.
I shall baptize you with water unto repentance, but he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. He is worthy.
We can even ask Peter, his disciple.
Lord, to whom shall we serve? Thou hast the words of eternal life, and we believe and are sure that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. He is worthy.
The woman at the well even believed he was worthy.
Come, see a man which showed me all the things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? He is worthy.
There was even Thomas, who doubted him, and yet in the end he still found him worthy.
My Lord and my God, he is holy.
As Christians, we are the only people who follow a leader who died and rose again. The tomb is empty. Every other major religious leader is dead. People have searched for years to find Jesus' body, but he is not here. He is risen, for he is worthy.
Good.
June 21st, 2020. He is worthy.
I was saved December 17, 2017. He is worthy.
The Lord saved me July 26, 2019. He is worthy.
Appreciate everybody coming. He is worthy, isn't he? I don't even really like to consider where I might be if it hadn't been for the grace of God coming to my life. I was thinking while they was doing the play about the scripture when Paul wrote to the Galatians. He said, in the fullness of time, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. God died for us so we could be his children, born again by the grace of God. I'm glad it's real. I say that a lot to my church. It's not religion. It's a real personal experience with Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm glad it makes a change in your life. Amen. I appreciate the Lord giving us this place, giving us this school. Appreciate what he's done. Some of these younger ones, if they've grown up, they've gotten born again, gotten saved, that's a blessing. And they come in, sometimes it'll be during the summer break, and they'll come in talking about getting saved during the summer, during revival. I thank the Lord for that. And that's the most important thing you need to do, make sure your relationship with God's right. And that's important. We've got to face eternity one day. I appreciate all these youngins. I appreciate you coming, being with us today. And it's a blessing, and I appreciate God giving us this place. All right, we're going to be dismissed.